Hello everyone, welcome to another special episode of CG Innovate. Today we have somebody really special, Ms. Anshul Bhatia. He's an emerging chef, a globetrotter, and a vlogger with who you can find on YouTube with a very special name of The Lusty Chef. So we are in this episode going to talk all about cuisines. We would like to know Anshul's journey from Bhilai to Dubai to Canada, where he's currently pursuing his master's from. So first of all, Anshul, a very, very warm welcome to you. And thanks for, agreeing to speak with us. And
it's a pleasure for me as well.
Yeah. Thank you. So Anshul, we would like to know about your journey. And we would like to know what's going on in the world of cuisines. So the stage is all yours. Please tell us about your interesting journey and what all things are you up to.
So my name is Anshul Bhatia, as you already tell everyone. So yeah, I'm a chef by profession. Not a chef, maybe a cook who is learning every day and trying to become a chef. I belong to a small town by the name Bhilai, which is for the world now. And I'm also trying to make it, become one of the famous place all over the world. So I studied from there, and almost like more than half of my life until now I spent there. And then I did my hotel management from Institute of Hotel Management, Hyderabad. From there on, I got selected into Hyatt Raipur, which is again a very good brand of hotel. It is like one of the, you can, for dream hotel company for any hotel. Then from there, I got to know about, to go abroad. So I was searching, and there was an opportunity. There was an interview happening going on in Mumbai. So I went there, I applied, I got selected. Then I went there. I went there to cook food for the staff, those who were working there in restaurant. But the hotel was not opened that time. So we were into pre-opening stage. So during that time, we used to have trainings and all. So that time, my executive chef, who was my boss, so he told me that, Anshul, I think you deserve a better place. He moved me from that staff cafeteria to a celebrity chef restaurant, Morimoto. It was owned by Chef Morimoto. So Chef Morimoto is also another story. This session is not like is very less for to talk about that topic. So then from Morimoto, things happened, things started changing. My personality changed. Even I lost my weight. I was around 110 kg. I lost my weight. I, tried to become a good. Still my photo is there, my picture is there on the wall of my so yeah, that all things happened. And then I got start getting recognitions as well. After this pandemic hit, lot of live sessions, and I decided to not to sit. So I there was a like kida bolte na, that I used to big YouTubers, so I used to think that maybe I can also do that, because I am no person like you guys. I am a chef, I know how to cook, but I don't know much about technology. But I learned with the time, and then I learned the basics of all the YouTube and social media and all. I think came on my way eventually, and then I used it very nicely. And also After that, slowly the YouTube increased. It is not big right now, but slowly it started showing me the fruit, not in terms of like finance, but recognition was the getting, because people started to know me. So from there on, I got motivated, and now I am sitting in between you guys and doing this interview.
Okay, thanks a lot, Anshul, for your in brief about your journey, and perhaps a different day for Morimoto story. So, okay. So let me ask you a few questions on the same line. One is, what were the qualities that you think made you a good chef? Second is, would you recommend people from the state to go more and more into this industry? And, you know, a message to people on the same lines of choosing this as a career. So, if you can change.
So, basically, being a chef is very difficult. Because you have to make a lot of sacrifices, first of all. And also, the timings are very tough in terms of working, because sacrifices not only in terms of your work, but you have to sacrifice your everything, because the job is demanding that kind of effort from your side. So for us, there is no, but like hardly we get the chance to celebrate our birthday or Diwali or New Year or something. So that emotion of festivals ultimately, you know, faded away. Like, and second thing is like, you have to be like very passionate. If you don't have passion, or if you just like cooking because you like to cook, it's not like that, because cooking part is only 50%. Rest, everything comes, like there is a paperwork, there are receiving, then you have to maintain hygiene and all. If you will cook a decent food, nobody gonna say anything to you. But if you will not follow the hygiene, then that is the problem. So there are a lot of factors. And also, most important thing is you have to keep your ego aside, because like, for example, we have to clean our kitchen, or every day we have to clean our kitchen. We have to take out the garbage bins, throw them in the dustbin, and then clean our kitchen, clean the sink. There are a lot of things in which the society which we were, you know, जहाँ से हम बड़े हो रहे हैं, the engineers or the doctors mentality from our parents and all, तो कहीं ना कहीं जाके वो एक ईगो में आ जाता है कि अरे मैं तो अच्छे खानदान से हूँ, मैं ये क्यों करूँ. But that kind of things make you strong, and you know, you will become capable to do anything, because lifetime tumko wo nahi karna hai. And second important, matlab most important thing is aapko padhai karna zaruri hai, hotel management ya culinary management, jo bhi aap padhna chahte ho, because bina padhe bhi aap chef ban sakte ho. Qualified nahi rahoge to aapko kya hai, promotion milne mein dikkat hoti hai, plus aapko theoretical knowledge bilkul bhi nahi rahega, नहीं मिलेगा. तो दीज आर द मेन फैक्टर्स जो आपको एक शेफ बनने में हेल्प करते हैं. और सेकंड जो आपके इस क्वेश्चन का सेकंड पार्ट है, दैट इज कि मैं किसी को रिकमेंड करूंगा क्या शेफ बनने के लिए, तो उसके लिए हमेशा आप पहले वाले पॉइंट ही करिए सबसे, कि आप ईगो को अपने साइड रखो, तो आपको मैं रिकमेंड करूंगा. मैं पर्सनली, आज भी मेरे को दिन में एक मैसेज आया कि मैं शेफ बनूं कि नहीं बनूं, और मेरे को इंटरेस्ट है कुकिंग में, बट मैं करूं कि नहीं करूं. तो मैंने उसको बोला, सी आई पर्सनली डोंट रिकमेंड एनीवन, बिकॉज शेफ बनने में क्या है, स्टार्टिंग में थोड़ा पैसा कम रहता है, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट, इट इज अ स्किल्ड जॉब. अंटिल एंड अनलेस यू डोंट नो हाउ टू कुक, और यू डोंट नो how to do the things properly. Even developing your taste bud also takes a lot of time. You need that taste bud. Even now I am practiced, like now I know I can smell the food and I can tell you that whether the salt is enough or not. So that comes with practice and everything. So you have to be patient enough that money will come, but it will not come initially. So if you are running behind money, chef job is not for you, because it will take some time. Second thing is, you have to be completely devoted towards your job. As I said, long, long shift hours, 18 hours, 24 hours, sometimes 36 hours. You have to stay in hotel. They will give you 2 hours of break, then come back, then work again. Sometimes you will not see your home for 3 days or 4 days. So job is very tough and very demanding.
Okay, thanks a lot, Anshul, for sharing those insights. Of course, anybody who wants to be a chef, as you rightly pointed out, needs sacrifices. To make sacrifices, has to be very passionate and dedicated, and to put the ego aside. So I think, those are fabulous insights, and people who are watching would definitely take a note of these, that it's not a piece of cake to put it in, to use a culinary idiom, and that yes, it will take a lot of effort to finally reach the level where you want to be. So thanks a lot, Anshul. It has been an enlightening talk.
Yeah, it's like it always feel good that someone from your home state or hometown, they are giving you some recognition or something like that, because you do hard work, or obviously to earn some money, but also to move forward we need appreciation, so that we feel motivated and we will keep working towards our target of making our hometown into some, giving the name of our hometown to a certain level. Like I remember when I was in Qatar, so that time we used to, one day our executive chef came and he said like, you have to write your name in the wall with the place you belong. So everyone was writing like in under the India, like Delhi, 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 Mumbai, Delhi, Mumbai, Delhi, Mumbai. And in the middle of all those, I wrote my name, Anshul Bhatia, Bhilai, Chhattisgarh. So whether I am not there, but still that name is there. Still, if 1,000 people are working in that hotel, maybe one person at least will get to know the name of the place from where I belong. And lucky enough, I know that my picture is also there in the wall of that hotel until now. That picture also changed a lot of equations. Everything was good. Now I am into better place, hopefully, Canada. And from now, my target is to whatever I did previously, left all those things at that point, and now I have to do something more big.
Yeah, thanks, Anshul. We wish you complete success. We wish you spectacular success in your efforts, and that you really make a name for yourself. And as a consequence, Bhilai also gets known by people. So, it has been lovely speaking with you. Take care, and all the best from TechMint and the CG Innovate team. Thanks a lot.
Thanks to you guys as well. Take care, everyone. See you soon with another session.
Thanks. Yeah.
With new achievements and everything. Bye.
Bye bye.